Everyone can go to the Father. Can you just go to the Father? Lord Jesus, we pray tonight. Thank you, Father. For in Jesus' precious name, I will pray. Our amen can be better. In Jesus' precious name, I will pray. Father, we thank you. We give you praise. Father, do us good tonight. Like never before, baptize us with your fire. Let it truly be a night of revival. Let it truly be a night of spiritual awakening. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. It is done. In Jesus' precious name, I will pray. Please be seated, Pastor. Amen. Alright. It's a charge I'm bringing to us tonight, and I will implore every one of us to listen to what God is bringing us. I was telling my brother, Pastor Destiny, I think earlier today, I said, what I'm ministering today, God gave me last week Monday, the day we lost the soil, and heaven gained up. That was the morning that God gave me this direction. So I encourage every one of us, those of us going back to school. I remember the last time Chidelis was here, I told us, I said, record the message. When we came for retreat, and I believe God really helped us that night. Something like that is coming again to us today. And those of us who are not with who, we can record. I'm doing a record with the phone of one of us. This is one of the messages that we will keep playing. Okay, tonight we'll be speaking on the topic, the higher priesthood. The higher priesthood. Let me share a revelation I had last week Monday before going further. Last week Monday, before we went to work, I saw, it was like I was in a battle field or something, a stage. And there was one aged man. The man was holding a stick or a rod of authority. So I confronted the man. And when I confronted the man, I used this thing. I come with the higher priesthood. I defeated the man by the grace of God. I collected the rod or the authority from the man, and the man was on the ground. Every one of us here, represented here, are families. Represented here are individuals. Represented here are many of us with so many issues. And tonight God is bringing the world to us, a higher priesthood. So before I go any further, who is a priest or what is a priesthood? A priesthood is an office. A priesthood, it is an office. It is not a person. It is an office. When you hear the word principality, principality is not a person. Principality is an office. Praise God. Are we together tonight? Please, very briefly, we'll be praying. But before we pray, it's needful that we have understanding. So that when we are praying with understanding. When we leave this place, we leave with understanding. Amen. Now I said, a priesthood. Priesthood is an office. Principality is an office. It is the person that wears or that stays in the office that is called a priest. Praise God. And the contention tonight is that there are two kinds of priesthood. We have the priesthood from the kingdom of light, and we have the priesthood from the kingdom of darkness. Are we together tonight? Please, everybody, listen. It's going to be very brief. But I trust that God will meet us at the point of our needs tonight. There are two kinds of priesthood. There is the priesthood from the kingdom of light, and there is the priesthood from the kingdom of darkness that we must be aware about tonight. So I said, the one that stays in that office, for family, what you have is a priesthood. For a territory, what you have is a principality. So let's read scripture. Okay, let me define a priest. A priest is a person. A priest is a person that is in charge, that allows and rejects in a family or in a place. A person that allows, okay, I allow you to come into my house. I allow you to bring your stuff into my house. No, don't come into my house. I'm in charge of this. The priest is the person that is in charge. So for every family, there is a priest, you know. You may believe it, you may not. But this is the reality. There is a priest for every family. And this priest sometimes may not even be a pastor. The priest may not even be preaching in church every Sunday. The priest may be an usher, but there is a priest in every home. Let's read scripture. Luke 11 verse 20, 21 and 22. Luke 11 verse 20, 21 and 22. But if with the finger of God cast out devil, no doubt the kingdom of God is come unto you. Verse 21. When a strong man armed keepeth his palace, his goods are in peace. When a what? A strong man, right? Keepeth his goods, they are what? In peace. Now listen to what verse 22 says. But when a stronger than he shall come unto him and overcome him, he taketh from him all his armor wherein he trusted and defended his spoil. Please tell my brother to stand up and go to the back. Go to the back. Go. Well done. The chief. Thank you, Father. So he said, no, not there. Not, I didn't say you sit. Go and stand at the back. That's what I said. So he said, a strong man is in charge of his house. He tells what happens. He tells what would not happen. But when a stronger man comes, he dispossesses that strong man. You are the owner of the house, but now a stronger than you have come. And because that stronger than you have come, though it's your house, but that stronger than you is the one making decisions. So this is the reason why there are so many things happening in families, happening in a place, and you have done what you know to do best, but it's not working. Because there is a stronger man. Are we together tonight? Am I communicating to us? Because there is a stronger priesthood. Revelation 5:10. He said, and God has created us to be king and priest, even in the earth, to reign. God has created us to be king and priest to reign in the earth. Revelation 5 and verse 10. God has created us to be kings and priests to reign in the earth. So whether you are a male, we have a female in the house, or whether you are a female, a priest is a priest. The conference we are having now, the generational Deborah moment of prayer, in Judges 4 and verse 4, a woman was heading Israel for a season. She was what? A prophetess. A woman was judging Israel, the whole of Israel. A woman. So it means whether you are a male, whether you are a female, anyone that agrees to wear the garment becomes the priest of that house. Amen. Anyone that agrees to wear the garment becomes the priest of that territory. Anyone that agrees to stay, okay, no problem. It was existed or it was existing before I came. I am here now. I am ready to stay. Anyone that takes that decision becomes in charge. Sometimes we see what we don't like in our lives, in our families, in our businesses, even in our fellowships. We don't like these things. But actually, we have done all we know to do, but it's as though it's not working. What is responsible? Please listen, everybody. Something is responsible. If God truly opened your eyes to what is leaving us tonight, I am sure that many issues that we are asking, I am sure that this will be the answer. Yes, sir, I know what I'm saying. I'm sure that this will be the answer. The answer for poverty, I'm sure that this will be the answer. A priest is one that opens the door. You can open your door to prosperity. Yes, sir. You can open your door to break through what have you. A priest is the one that opens. So the question I'm asking tonight, who opens the door in our family?
Yes, sir.
Amen. Amen. Who opens the door in our businesses? Who have taken the stage? I said there are two kinds of priests. Whether you are a male, whether you are a female, that does not really count. What counts is the one that makes the command. Even if there are 200 soldiers, the one with the highest rank is the one that gives the order. And when he gives the order, whether you are 1 million of you, you must obey the last command. The one that gives the order is the priest. And see, scripture speaking in Ezekiel 22 and verse 30, he said, I stand and I search for a man that will stand in the gap. I am searching for the one that will stand in the gap and say, Lord, a suffered too much. My business, my ministry has suffered too much. I agree to stand. I will all the days of affliction. Job said, I will wait until I see my change come. I agree to stand and wait. So God is telling us today, there is a need for a priesthood to be erected. He said, I have made you a king and a priest to rule over the earth. Do you know what it means? Only a priest rule. Only a king rule. So if you are anything lesser than this, sir. Ecclesiastes said, I have seen priests walking on earth and servants on what? On horses. So if you agree tonight that, okay, I want to remain the way I am, that's okay. But if you agree with God tonight, please touch Pastor Destiny for me. Stand up. So if you agree tonight, alright, that Father, I am taking the stage of my life. If you agree tonight, that Father, this is where we have been over the years. But right now, I think it is time that I'm going to take the seatbelt for my life and my destiny. That's what God is telling us tonight. A higher priesthood. Thank you, Father. Amos 3 and verse 7. Scripture speaking, he said, God doeth nothing except he reveals it to his servant first. Yes, so he will not do anything except he has first of all revealed it to your servant. It will be an error if an outsider, Mashaga, Bana, Kota, Pinata, is the one coming to tell you, God, you guys should pray against me. So it's a big error. Yes, sir. And I said, everyone coming to your house, and every one of you in this house, observe 3 days fasting. The enemy wants to afflict you. There's an accident, an outsider. When God has said, I have made you a king and a priest to rule in the earth, an outsider is not the one coming. It means that you will not actually sit in. You will not actually take the seat of the family. Is God helping us tonight? Favor. Very nice. So he said, God does nothing except he first of all reveals it to his servant. Amos 3 and verse 7. So what has God brought to you for your house? You know, last week, I myself and my older brother, we woke up in the morning and we prayed. And I was like, see the dream I had. He said, he had the same dream. The same night. And as a result of that, we called all our siblings, our parents as well. Let's be on a day fast and all of that. He gave it to me, he gave it to my older brother. Not an outsider. So it's a question I'm asking. Who receives the direction for the house? Somebody has to receive the direction for the house. Somebody has to take the stage for the house. Whether you are a male or you are a female, first or last, somebody has to step the stage for the house. So in Daniel 10, Scripture said, now something happened. Daniel started praying. God, when would you release us from this captivity of Babylon? And Scripture said, that day God heard the prayer. And God sent Angel Gabriel. But Angel Gabriel could not pass. You know why? In this realm, we wrestle not against flesh, not against blood, but against principalities and power. So even an archangel, Angel Gabriel, could not pass a principality. The reason is simple. God understands the meaning of priesthood. God understands the meaning of ranking. When negative things happen to us, we are asking God, are you there? He's really there. He saw it all. And he told you. See my brother Richard is putting his hand on the job. Well done. Before that thing happened, God saw it and he told you, this is what is going to happen. The radio, I remember something happened. I was telling Pastor Destiny yesterday. I said, if you remember, Richard was here. He was here, Pastor Destiny. When we were painting it, when we did this wallpaper. I said that night, Richard, if you remember, I said, we're going to pray. I was saying, see, remember, I said something like that. Did we pray? We did not pray, we said. What was that? I us tonight. Please listen, oh, please listen. I know where I'm coming from. I know what I'm bringing to us. So God told us something that time. I was receiving a negative signal, and I know what that signal means. I said it 2, 3, 4, 5 times. I said, once you guys are done with your rehearsal, we are going to pray. By the time they were done with the rehearsal, I already entered the bed crying. Ah, the bed was sweet. And the sleep was sweet. So we slept. I was praying when he came the other day, and I said, God, see what God told me. That the most first in the revelation. Who is God giving that direction in the house? If you are not the one, there is a need for a confession. There is a need to cry. Father, I am available. It is time we are the one that speaks over our family. God, this family has not moved. We have been like this for a very long time. It is time we move. It is time we take that stage. We take that seat. So Daniel made a prayer. And the angel Gabriel came. But the angel Gabriel could not pass. You know what we stood in? It was the passion. The position was principality. But the person that was in that office was passion. So it's called the priest of passion. The grand is in scripture. It's priest of passion. So there was a priest. The land is passion. So there was a priest in charge of that place. And he would tell Gabriel. Gabriel could not come. God understands ranking. God understands priesthood. So Daniel continually prayed. And God has said, okay, let me now send Michael so that we can bring that priesthood down. A strong man's possession is saved until a stronger man comes and dispossesses that man from all his arm. Tying the book of Luke 11, verse 21 and 22. So when a stronger angel came, he broke that priesthood. An answer came for Daniel. So it means that if we have been praying and trusting God for certain things and it has not come, perhaps there is actually a priesthood that has been there before we came. We must press on. I testify of the goodness of God. 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 One more time, God, ecosh about God. And it's as though the prayer did not fall. Listen, I told a number of us last month, I said, let us start the platform, intercessory platform, praying for the nation. Sir, I've been praying for the nation personally. But there are some prayers that an individual cannot obtain. Because we are confronting principality. Principality is an office of a territory. Are we together? So I said, I need more persons. You never been able to pray for women for Nigeria, a moment of prayer. People all around, all the verses I gave that responsibility to, they were all from the seat of the political zone of Nigeria. All the verses are led prayer. It was not as though an individual cannot lead prayer, sir. We needed people from different territories to speak against the principality. So the reason why sometimes when it's time to pray, they say, no, you are the one to pray for your family because of the blood you shed. I've been in cases where I pray for somebody and almost immediately the thing is working. So many times I pray for somebody and the thing is not working. And I'm asking God, why? He said, except two persons agree as talking a thing. Therefore, sorry, can two work together except they agree? So you come and tell me, son, can two work together except they agree? There must be a priesthood in that house. So when you add your priesthood to that priesthood, it works. For when there are no priesthood there, it is just your priesthood. Let's go. Let me get you something to do this. You want to pray. But before we start praying, It is needful that we agree with God. Father, it is time I take over. It is time I take over. It is time I take over. Thank God for how far God has helped us. But there is more. Even for our family, there is what? There is more. So when Michael came, Michael broke that priesthood. Because before we came, there was a priesthood. There was who? That's why we pray against covenants. Anybody that tells you covenant does not come is not true. It works. It exists. Covenants are really in existence. Somebody sang this altar. Something happened before we came. And that agreement made the legislature to stand. And when we are coming to say, God, that thing will not stand again. What happened in the book of Daniel? Where there was a principality and a stronger principality came and dispossessed that principality is what happened. Did you see? Did you saw what Daniel did? Daniel was consistent. He did not stop praying. He was praying. God, when would you bring my answer? When would you bring this that I'm praying for? And God had him. After the first day, God brought. But he did not stop. Because there was a priesthood already. Before Daniel came to Babylon, before they were captured, there was a priesthood. Pesha was already there. And he was going to break the priesthood of Pesha. So he kept praying and fasting. For the last 21 days, he was praying and fasting. So, this is not the kind of prayer you make one day and you say you are dry. When scripture said, for the path of the just is as a shining light that shines brighter and better. It is not only in the path of success, it is in the path of battle. Because you won the battle yesterday, it's not enough to go and sleep. Bible says if you cast out a demon from an individual, the demon goes to the wilderness, and when he gets there and he does not find a body, he comes back with seven more stronger demons. He thinks that if you cast out yesterday, today be ready for seven more. Thank God for the battle of yesterday. But if you go to sleep, because you won yesterday, sir, you will not wake up on that sleep. Hallelujah.
Are we together tonight?
Because it takes a priest to legislate the will of God. So something happens. All of these are the priests who can see the sense. You are left to stand when you are seated. Something happens. We're about praying. A tenant told me last year. Okay, a person told me last year. The person is here. And okay, the person told me so. And we pray. So when we pray, when we now pray for people outside Nigeria, I told us to pray. I did not put anybody on the fast. That person placed himself or herself on the fast. The person is like the last in the house. But even from the first, they consult this person. He's not even a male, he's a she. All the male in the house, they consult this person. A priest. If does not nothing happen, my embassy tonight is Amos 3:7. It does nothing, he will first of all reveal it to his servant. His servant is not the pastor in church. He is in charge of that congregation. In the house, he has servants in every house. Did you see what happened in Goshen, in Egypt? Did God tell them to stay in one place and just put the door at the doorpost? No. Everyone put the door at your own house doorpost. Was that what not what happened? When the angel of death came, he was moving from house to house. So God deals with us on house basis, family basis. Because the altar in your family is different from my altar. If the grace I carry to consume and contain the grace, the power that be in my family, it will not be able to contain. So you need to start to show me. Don't do that. A higher priesthood. A higher was priesthood. Then he said, this family, okay, I know the way it was yesterday. It will not be again. And God said, I, my daughter has said it. My son has said it. It will not be like. See, these things are real. It is real. Thank God for a moment of prayer. Nothing happened on the platform that God was not revealed to me. Nothing, not one. That happened and that was happened. Not one. Except this one moment of prayer. Not one. There is nothing that happened that God no. Because He has made me in charge of that platform. That's how God has made you in charge of the house. Made you in charge of the house. Made you in charge of the house. Made you in charge of your business. That's how He has made all of us. But what is lacking? Many times we do not take the seat. And we get orders from people. And we do not agree to take that seat. And content as that man contented, those orders are still taking the view. Who is ready to do it? Say, Father, tonight, I know things have happened before. If I knew this better, maybe I would have stayed more at the place of prayer. Maybe I would have even fasted more. Maybe I would have avoided many things. The water that is other than you are, that's the water you want to confront. You don't confront that water from the place of comfort. But we wrestle against the shadow. But against principality, against power, against rulers of darkness, in our Jesus. Not in Israel. So when we begin to contend tonight, say, Father, I take over that position. You must understand what you are doing. There is a strong man already there. And you want to dispossess that strong man. That is the understanding we are praying with tonight. Somebody has been there already. Nothing else happened in your house. No, there is no luck in the kingdom of life. Nothing like law. Nothing. If it's not favor, it's not favor. There is nothing like law. Maybe you read your Bible and see there's anything like law. Nothing like law. Before I get law, okay. I get law. There's nothing like law. It's either you are favored or you are favored. So the reason why sometimes mountains are being out, a blessing is almost getting to you. All of a sudden, the blessing stops. And you have seen it not once, not twice, not three times, not four times. The one who gives you, the friend called me, okay, I think we'll be doing that for Monday. And the person said, okay, we're praying. I said, oh, my friend, we're praying. And God said, this. And he went to tell the person. And the person is true. The person now called and said, it's true. Somebody promises me. And everything is working on the person. When is exactly the time that person is to give me that particular stuff, all of a sudden, that thing that the person is supposed to give me, all of a sudden, the thing will not come again. So maybe somebody promised you money. At the end of the month, I will give you this amount of money. That is the month. That is the month. That because of that person will now say, I'm not paying this month. Yes, sir. It's not a mistake. It's not that you are unfortunate. There is a priest regulating. A strong man is in charge of his house until a stronger man comes and possesses him. So tonight we are taking the book by the book, saying we are a stronger man. We must hope for that. All of the scripture you read was, you are tired here too long. Speak of your bed. Amen. So what is calling us? It's a spiritual awakening. Where our dreams are alive. So when you see what the devil has planned, wake up and say, in the name of Jesus, go back to say that. I'm in charge of this house. I'm still here. I'm not leaving my position. I'm not leaving my seats. And because I'm still here. Last year, as I closed, did you know one consistent thing that happened in scripture? In the land of Israel, which is God's people, every time a leader falls, another leader comes up. There was never a time that a leader left and there was no leader. God will never lie about people. Never you think that, okay, let me just relax and enjoy myself. There is somebody that is there. It's either the kingdom of Christ or darkness. God never for once allowed the children of Israel to go without a leader. If Moses is going to fall, then Joshua should stand. Even in the area of prophets, if Elijah is going to go, then Elijah should be around.
So I don't know why your house is like this. Maybe the house is empty. Maybe there's nobody there. He said it does not do anything to stop rebuilding those houses. He must rebuild.
Oh, thank you, Father. This is the night where we take the hope by the wall.
We are not just praying, God, give me ministry. We are not just praying, God, give me a son, God, give me a wife. We are not just praying, God, give me money. We are not just praying. Our prayer is, Father, tonight I take the seat of authority. Nothing will happen in this house again except I am a man. Don't be afraid to do. Nothing happened in this place anymore except I permit it. God said, I stand and I search for a man that will stand in the gap, but I pray no. I find no. One of the things God told me that I think this month, and I told the German people, they were supposed to ask that today, but because the cast they are not yet. And maybe the devil knew what they wanted to bring. Now, I was praying that day, and while I was praying, I was waiting to hear from God. And I explained that scripture, Ezekiel 22 and 30. I sought for a man that would stand in the gap, I ran up. Now, while I was praying, I spent more than 30 minutes there. I did not hear anything from God. So it started raining. So I wanted to come out from the place I was, so that I can quickly carry the stuff outside so that it doesn't get wet. Was that not a good idea? It was right. I was about going, and the Holy Spirit said I should not go. But something just happened and I did not go. I remember it. That was when God started speaking. Because I did not go. So if I had left, maybe my answer would have come immediately I left. What was I going to do? It's still good. So that my stuff does not get spoiled. Because our spiritual things, they don't just adjust for physicality. If it is not carrying a weight in the realm of the spiritual, what's the matter? So it was that minute that I said, okay, let rain even fall on those stuff. Sir, did you know what happened? The rain fell in the But I left the place of prayer, left my answer to go there and come back. The angel of God would have come to say, okay, son, this. Perhaps he would have come and would now see me there and go back. And I would be crying, God, you don't answer prayer. God, why? I prayed yesterday. And God is saying, God, I said that in there, when you came to the I saw for a man to stand for God. From home. Daniel kept standing. He kept praying until that day God now said, okay, let me send my head. God deployed to Archangel. Gabriel, Archangel, the first point. Gabriel was with the prince of Persia. He was 1 point everywhere. God has said, okay, my dear, go and join Gabriel. Because somebody was praying, not for me. Are we right? Let's pray to God. God, we ask for strength. Can we just put each other together to be stretching, to hear the prayer, to hear the session, to be stretching? Can we ask God for strength? God, strength. We need this spiritual stamina and energy. God, strength, everyone, we have God for strength. Mate, go, Papa. We have heard God speaking to us tonight. Can we ask God for strength? La Rosete Cabratela. Can we ask God for strength? Everyone, please, we have strength. Take any position you want to take. My concern tonight is this. We are living with the higher ones. Please do God, we ask for strength. I am not going to motivate you. You have heard this prayer. You know the way your family is like. You want a movement. You want a change. You want a growth. You want an experience that you have never experienced before. Lord, I ask the man for strength. Strength to wait. Strength not to retire. Strength to remain. Man, take over. Can we pray tonight? Can we pray tonight? It's an outcry. I sought for a man that will stand at the gap. I find none. So therefore, I will be available. Come rain, come sunshine. Can we cry?